paid my dues. Time after time, I've done my sentence, but committed no crime. And bad mistakes, I've made a few. I've had my share. Hello, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the newest entry in my video blog. Well, for those of you who follow baseball, you know that it was pretty much around this time last night that the professional baseball team, the Chicago Cubs, managed to win the 2016 World Series Championship. After 108 years of not being able to get to the World Series. Yeah, because, as it turns out, it's been 108 years since the last time that the Cubs tried to get to this point. Now, of course, for those of you who tend to stay up rather late, I'm pretty sure you heard all of the fireworks going off at just around this time last night after the Cubs won the 2016 World Series Championship. Now, from what I'm aware of, I believe the mayor of Chicago, Rahm Emanuel, has put plans in place for the city to have a celebration in honor of the 2016 World Series champion Chicago Cubs. I believe that there's supposed to be a parade, I believe, at what? Sometime around 10 o'clock this Friday morning. Now, of course, I myself am not really, you know, that much of a sports fan. I don't really follow sports, but, you know, nonetheless, regardless, I would like to congratulate the Chicago Cubs on having won the 2016 World Series Championship, as it's something that they needed after 108 years of not being able to get to this point. Now, for those of you like me who follow political news, you are aware of how many people have been calling for the director of the Federal Bureau of Investigation, the FBI, James Comey, to step down as director of the FBI based on charges of abuse of power and violating the Hatch Act. He has also been criticized from many former FBI officials, and I believe even Justice Department officials, for even violating some of the Bureau's sort of unwritten policies, especially the fact of saying what he has said this close to next week's presidential election, which occurs next Tuesday. So, we shall see how things play out there. Now, from what I am currently aware of, as far as next Tuesday's presidential election, from what I have become aware of, multiple prediction polls are currently giving next Tuesday's presidential election to the Democratic nominee for president, Secretary Hillary Rodham Clinton. Now, in the last video, I told you about the odds that Nate Silver's 538 is giving to Secretary Clinton. I also told you about that polling firm, Target Smart, about how they surveyed early and likely voters in Florida, and about how, by the looks of it, if the numbers in Florida continue the way they are right now, that Donald Trump more than likely will lose the presidential election. I'm not exactly sure if I've stated, but the fact that, from what I've heard, Secretary Clinton currently has quite a few paths to the White House, whereas Donald Trump only has one. That path for Donald Trump, of course, being through Florida. Now, if it ends up being that Donald Trump loses Florida, he pretty much loses the election. Now, I recently came across a news article online where Secretary Clinton has called for the prosecution of WikiLeaks and its founder, editor-in-chief, and director, Julian Assange, after WikiLeaks, within like the past few months or so, leaked diplomatic cables about certain things that the United States government was doing overseas. Now, if you have an account on Twitter, you are aware of the fact that WikiLeaks, through their Twitter account, has been releasing what they claim to be emails from Senator Clinton's campaign manager, John Podesta. They have released, I believe so far, 28 parts in a series they have come to call Podesta Emails. Now, soon after WikiLeaks, through their Twitter account, started posting links to the emails, multiple sites began putting forth proof that, first of all, Russian hackers had hacked the Democratic National Committee in order to more or less steal the emails from John Podesta. And that, number two, that those same Russian hackers then proceeded to either forge and or severely edit the emails before releasing them to WikiLeaks. Meaning that once the Russian hackers gained possession of the emails, they either added to the amount by creating completely fake emails, or they went through and severely edited the emails, removing parts here and there to make the email release look damning to Secretary Clinton and her presidential campaign. Now, there's been quite a few hits to Republican, or to the Republican nominee for president, Donald J. Trump, specifically to his presidential campaign. Number one is that, well, as of right now, he still refuses to release his tax returns. He has used the claim that he is currently under audit by the IRS, which I believe is true. However, it has been stated to him he is allowed to release his tax returns for years where he isn't being audited. Most people are hypothesizing that the reason Trump refuses to release his tax returns is because his tax returns may show proof of him having business ties or some sort of business relationships in Russia. Another big hit to his campaign is now 12 women who have accused Donald Trump of some form of sexual assault. As it turns out, most people are saying that, well, these 12 women are simply backing up the claims that Donald Trump made in that now infamous Access Hollywood footage, where he was talking to Billy Bush in some sort of tour bus. Of course, that footage also resulted in Billy Bush more or less being fired from MSNBC because of some of the stuff that he said in the video, plus his attitude. Now, one of the biggest hits to Donald Trump's campaign is, of course, the fact that I believe it's next month, maybe in December, there is a hearing for Donald Trump's underage rape trial, where he is being sued, I believe, by a woman, I believe, for having raped an underage girl. So, depending upon how things go with that, it could be that if Donald Trump loses the presidential election next week, he could go on to possibly end up in jail if convicted of underage rape. And of course, the currently Republican-controlled Congress apparently has stated its intent on holding multiple hearings on Secretary Clinton should she be elected president after next week's election. They also stated their intent to block any nomination that Secretary Clinton might make to the Supreme Court should she be elected president. Now, that is a little bit of hypocrisy because of the fact that back when President Obama nominated Merrick Garland to replace the former late Antonin Scalia as a Supreme Court justice, the Republican-controlled Congress made their belief known that they figured that the next president should nominate a replacement for Justice Scalia. However, they are now stating that should Secretary Clinton win the election, they would refuse to do their constitutional duty as far as it relates to whomever Secretary Clinton nominates to the Supreme Court should she be elected president. Well, ladies and gentlemen, I suppose that is about it for this video blog entry. I would like to thank all of you for tuning in to this video blog entry as well as to my video blog itself. So, I will see all of you right back here next time. So, as I always say, you know, be kind to one another, take care of yourself and each other. So, until next time, thank you for tuning in. I paid my dues. Time after time, I've done my sentence, but committed no crime. And bad mistakes, I've made a few. I've had my share and kept it. So once again, I would like to congratulate the 2016 World Series champion Chicago Cubs for having gotten to the World Series after 108 years and winning. So I thank you all for tuning in, and I will see you all next time. Until then, you know, take care of yourselves and each other, and have a great day, everyone.